call it and the time is right. And still you're telling me you have to go. Before you leave, there's something you should know. Yeah, something you should know, babe. I've seen you smiling in the summer sun. I've seen your long hair flying when you run. I've made my mind up that it's meant to be. Someday, lady, you'll accompany me. Someday, lady, you'll accompany me.
Okay, we're back. Thank you for joining me. I'm glad you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys enjoyed that intermission. We're still back here on the subject of crashing and burning. Crashing and burning. Gonna get these guys in focus, bear with me. There we go. Getting back to that air filter setup. I was looking for different things around the shop that I could use for the air filter. It wasn't just a quick, that solution, two solutions I just showed you. There were multiple crash and burns that Sunday, in addition to the ones I've just talked about. That one looked like a great piece right there. That's actually a little filter from your water sprinklers, your lawn sprinklers. They all have a little filter built inside. That would have been perfect. Just cut it off, put a flat piece on top. However, as I handled the object, I noticed the plastic. This is a slippery, it's kind of like a Delrin type or what they call engineering plastic. It's very slippery. It's done that way for a purpose so it doesn't dry out, and so it could... It almost acts like a lubricant, even though it's not a lubricant. It's slippery, so it could move around. You see them in model railroading on freight car trucks, plastic freight car wheels. KD Couplers makes plastic Delrin couplers for the same reason. But that's what this is. Problem is, you'll never get glue to work on it, and you'll never get paint to adhere to it. So this is a no-no. That's another crash and burn. Another happy little tree or pissed off little tree. Sorry, Bob Ross. Second piece. I was trying to kind of goof around with this and I was cutting it down. And as I figured the edges were kind of, you could see the cut marks on the edges. So I figured I'd clean them up with a file. As I attached the file to it and I cleaned it up, a sanding stick, it would get fuzzy all around. I could never get rid of those fuzzies. I'm not talking fuzzy like a... like hair, like what you'd find under your armpit. This is a cover for the little, on your Dremel cutting, on your Dremel tool, the little tiny ultra thin carbon cutting disc come in this little container about an inch tall, and it's round. It's a plastic container with a blue lid. Well, that's the blue lid. Another problem with that blue lid, once again, it's some sort of Delrin type plastic, or what they refer to as engineering plastic sometimes. So glue's not going to adhere to it. Paint is not going to adhere to it. Plus, I had all those fuzzies. So that's another crash and burn that I went through yesterday. How many are we up to now? So another unhappy little tree right there. And trying to cut this stuff, look at how many little... This is the tiny little cutting disc wheel I was talking about, how thin that is, that the container comes in. But just cutting, doing multiple cuts yesterday. You always break a couple of these. And I think I broke about three of them yesterday. So there's another crash and burn. And I was not a happy camper. There's another unhappy little tree. let me bring out this one. This explains it better. You guys remember that engine stand I was displaying the Detroit diesel and this Ford V8 on? I love it. It's great. On the Detroit diesel, it worked perfectly. For some reason, on the AMT Ford V8, it's not working as well. But I'm assuming because it's really light and a lot smaller than the Detroit diesel. The Detroit diesel was made out of resin, and it was really heavy, and it was a large block of resin. So I'm noticing as I'm shooting videos and trying to explain as I glue pieces on the engine, this every time I touch something, this thing would go down a little bit. I didn't like that unsteadiness when I'm trying to do something methodically, very slow, detail work. So that, I guess you can consider a crash and burn, no? So at least on this AMT Ford V8, keep in mind, I put weight in the engine. There's weight in that transmission. There's weight in the block. So it's got a good weight to it now, but still it would dance on it. And you can see the dancing right there. So my solution to that, now we're starting to get happy little trees. My dear friend, the late Ed Campbell, when he passed away, I mean, we roamed the country for about 25 years, close to 30 years. Going to every freaking train show you can imagine between here and Canada, the East Coast, the West Coast, down through Texas, you name it, we went. And we caused hell wherever we went, man. We're both heavy-duty drinking men, and we love to have a good time. And the great thing about those shows, if you ever get to go to them, they're usually held in a nice fancy hotel like the Hilton or Sheraton or something like that. And yeah, it's a little bit pricey, but you know what? You're staying in the hotel. You don't have to drive. All those hotels have a nice restaurant down there and a big giant bar. So guess what we spent 25 years, actually about 28 years doing? We had a blast. When my brother Ed Campbell passed, it hit me real hard, and I have not been in one of those shows since. And I the model railroading bug kind of died. And I've heard a lot of people say that throughout the years. He gave me all his workshop tools, bunch of parts, stuff like that. And his family, once he passed, his family gave me the rest of them. So rather than stick them in a box in the attic or put them on eBay, they're here in the shop. They got mixed with my stuff. I got a lot of tools, a lot of neat stuff, a lot of parts, and I'm using the hell out of them because that's what my buddy would have wanted. And remember what I said about the people, the friends you're going to meet in this hobby, hopefully will be for your lifetime or a lifetime. This is what I'm talking about, okay? I just told a couple people, actually, yesterday, another fellow model roller that called me from San Diego yesterday. We were talking, and another model roller buddy of mine out in Arkansas, Bill. So Al and Bill gave me a call back-to-back, on, you know, one from San Diego, one from Arkansas. And I told him the story about that, and I told him that I was the one that gave the eulogy at Fred's funeral. I'm sorry, Ed's funeral. They were surprised about that, but it's probably one of the most beautiful things I've ever done in my lifetime. This hobby is going to take you guys places. You young people, you new people, you guys going back in the hobby, seniors, military vets, disabled vets, doesn't matter. Young ladies, young women, older women, doesn't matter. If you have an artistic side to you and you choose to dabble in this, but if you choose to really get into this, the people you're going to meet along the way are going to blow you away. And you're probably going to have friends for the rest of your life. Anyways, I don't want to bum anybody out. No more angry little trees. Now I'm starting to get happy little trees. So check this out. This thing, as I apply the parts on there, I'll put a piece of blue tape on there across the transmission. It'll hold it down, and that way I can add the parts when I film this tomorrow without having to worry about that dancing I was having. That thing ain't going anywhere once I put that piece of tape on there. Finally, we're starting to get happy little trees. Now, I cleaned out the workbench, and I said, I'm going to shoot some videos regarding this particular subject. There's more. We're almost done. Now, getting back to unhappy little trees. Let me bring back this guy here. So I decided to add spark plug wires to the AMT V8. So using the AMT distributor, which I painted black, I drilled a big hole on the inside, and I got some wires, some real flexible wires I picked up at the hobby store here a couple months ago. and I had my wires going. But because I was having trouble with this original ugly filter that was incorrect, I had glued it in place. It just became a big mess. I had to pull the original distributor out once I had crazy glued it in, ruining it. The wires, I thought I could save them. They got all mangled. They look like a tarantula or a daddy long leg spider that had just gotten stepped on by an angry shoe. Oops. So I did have some nice distributor and wire kit that I picked up at Brookhurst Hobbies here also a couple months ago. I said, you know what? I've been holding on to this for a while. I don't know why. Let's go ahead and use it on this guy here. So I decided that at work today also. So we'll put her here. We'll affix her to the block. We'll attach the spark plug cables where they got to go. Then we'll add the air filter, the bellows, or the heat duct, whatever it's called, exhaust duct or whatever, hot air duct, and other things. You'll see that tomorrow when we do the other build. So with the distributor, that distributor cap that I told you I just ruined, and the spark plug wires that I ruined, there's two more crash and burns. So how many crash and burns are we up to in the last, on a Sunday, in one day? Isn't that up to about 9 or something like that? Well, no more crash and burns. We got happy little trees again with this guy, with this guy, with this guy. Definitely with this guy. So I wanted really to make this video for you young people. Down the road, many years from now, when someone attempts to do this build and wants to doll her up, someone's going to mention, hey, some knucklehead on YouTube's got a whole series on these. He refers to these videos. I refer to these videos now as my shop manual, your shop manual. So hopefully these experiences will help you guys way down the road, even after I'm long gone. We all crash and burn, every single one of us. You saw me crash and burn previously with the Freightliner, the diamond reel. Let me show you one more thing. Let me show you one more thing before we call it a day as far as this video is concerned. Let's put this truck over here on the side. You hear me talk about this all the time. To those of you who live by yourself, or you're far away from, way far away, depending where you live, from other modelers, a hobby store, with the internet today, you have a group, a large group, actually a group worldwide, all around the world, and I've talked to many of them, that you can always ask, and they will be more than happy to help you out. If I'm not around, or you don't have access to my videos, and you get stuck in a funk, or you're working on a totally different project than anything I ever worked on, and you just need to guidance, or just to clear your head, or see how others do it, I always mention the University of Modelers. That's kind of like a, that's just a fun, goofy name I call it. But really, if you guys ever get a chance, and I hope John Paul doesn't mind, check out John Paul's YouTube live group. I highly, highly, highly recommend. He's up to like way over 1,000 subscribers. He's on here every night. You can either participate, just ask your question and get out. You can sit on the sidelines and just listen. You can contact these guys later offline. And but check out John Paul's live group. This is a fantastic place to cut your teeth, to get knowledge, experience, have your questions answered. I've done a couple crash and burn live videos on his live group. Those were crash and burn videos. I had those exhaust stacks that I was bending metal tubing. I had just gotten the tool to bend it. And we did the first bend on John Paul's live group. And the thing exploded and sand and salt went everywhere. And we all had a great laugh. That was a big crash and burn. And actually, that one was live. Really live on YouTube and internet. Went all over the world. So I had people probably laughing at me from all over the place. So how many crash and burns am I up to here? You get the drift what I'm trying to say. Don't let anything in life, don't let anything in model building, in your personal life, your love life, your family life, your job, defeat you. Conquer it with knowledge. It's what God give you a brain for. Questions. Look up stuff. Google it now. Do your research. Don't be afraid to do that. Get away from instant gratification when you deal with this, because this requires patience. And no one's going to give you that patience but yourself. So, and never, ever, ever, ever be afraid to ask an older adult, hey, how do I do this? Ask a question. Trust me, you're going to get some great answers and life experience. Older people do not bite. I do not bite. Anyone can ask me anything. You can ask me directions to where the nearest Jack in the Box is. I'll be more than happy to tell you. That's the way life is, and that's the way the world is. We hand off our knowledge to you young people, the next generation, the future of this world, the future of the human race. So let's stop any bickering. You see all the bullshit that's going on in the world right now. This whole freaking planet is about to explode, almost, it seems. We're not going to participate in that. We, as a people, need to calm ourselves down, because we can't rely on politicians to do that for us. We calm ourselves down. Thank you, Bob Ross, for letting me, inspiring me as I was growing up as a kid and watching you paint, and influencing me with positivity is what I'm trying to do here for you guys here. So I do crash and burn. I crash and burn a lot. And I crash and burn how many times? About 9, 10, 11 times in one day alone. And that was yesterday. So, but I guarantee you, that truck is going to come out like $1 million. So, let's end it here. Let's end it right about here. I'll put the truck back out so you guys can check it out. Something I did do to the truck that you guys may notice, or maybe not. Probably will notice in this shot here. Is I went ahead, like all my vehicles, I like to lift the back a little bit, slightly. That's what I did here, and I love that. But the real one also has that particular stance you're looking at right there. And I'll leave you again with some. Got a TV commercial. So I'll leave you going. I'll walk away from the room. I'll leave some music on. You guys check out the rig, the model. See if you get any ideas for what you're doing. And I'll leave you alone with Bob Seger on this beautiful, beautiful evening in Southern California on a nice, warm, but yet overcast Monday evening in the middle of April 2022. Everyone, grab that fun little kit project out of your stash that you've been holding on for who knows what. grab it out right now, build along with me, film it, let's talk, let's laugh, let's crash and burn together as the whole freaking world falls apart right before our eyes, but we're not gonna let it. Great hobby. Don't get discouraged. Keep it up. You're on the right track. Ask questions, and you're definitely 1,000% not alone. You guys take care. I love all you guys. Have an awesome week. We will meet together on the next video. Thank you for following my episodes and my series build. You guys are incredibly awesome. Take care.